Why did I choose law enforcement? I'm born of a black man and a white woman. To say that their relationship was looked at negatively in the early 80s is an understatement. My father being part of a marginalized group and wanting to answer the call for service to his community, he chose law enforcement. Not only to put food on the table for his family, but also to contribute to the society that has shaped the man he became. So I followed in those footsteps. The job is a self-rewarding one. You don't do it for the glory. You do it to help the children grow up in a protected environment and look at you in a position of authority and say, oh, he's a human being. He's just like I am. I can be like that or better. So those moments you take to heart, and those are the things that keep me going in this career. I've been doing this for about 13 years, and the most important aspect of this job is the ability to be empathetic. When we go to a call, it's usually somebody's worst day of their life. You have to have that in the back of your head, right? You have to be mindful of that and be compassionate towards the people that you're there for. This is not just a job. This is a lot more than that. The first 10 years of my law enforcement career was spent in Northern Virginia. I never felt tied to that community. I did some research on the Fredericksburg Police Department, and what I found was an agency that was trying to become more pragmatic in policing. I also saw their substantial commitment to engaging with the community, and I wanted to be part of that. Back in Scotland Yard, Sir Robert Peel, his principles of policing have never changed. Without the community, there is no police, and without the police, there's no community. We need each other, and it has to be a collaborative effort to sustain a propitious society. If you see me on the street, please come talk to me. I would love to engage in a conversation with you. And no matter how you feel about the profession or with the Fredericksburg Police Department in general, anytime you need us, we will be there for you, no matter what. I will offer this, any of those that are viewing this video that have that drive or that sense or calling to serve your community, that want to be a voice of the marginalized, I suggest you join your local law enforcement or your local police department, as I have and my father before me, to be that voice from within, to strive for that change.